1st, we moved to Midtown with the effort to redevelop the area around CrossRoads Mall.
Based on what we heard tonight, the demolition for CrossRoads seems to be set for about a year from now, right after the holidays.
You're also getting an exclusive look at the grand design to once again make CrossRoads a shopping destination.
And other than a few big box stores, CrossRoads Mall is mostly empty and has been for years. People are always asking us, when will that change?
We have some answers tonight, including your first look at the developer's 3D model.
Rob and Brandy, we learned last Friday that the change is definitely on the way here for CrossRoads Mall.
We are learning more about the multi-million dollar plan to raise CrossRoads Mall in Omaha. The developer, who set his sights on the project, now needs more time to pull off the ambitious redevelopment.
The plan to turn this Omaha eyesore into a place where you can live, eat, and shop won't move forward as fast as first pitched. Rod Yates now says his vision for the old CrossRoads Mall will come in two parts.
300,000 square feet of retail, 300,000 square feet of office, 200 residential units in the first phase.
It once ruled Omaha's shopping scene as a cutting-edge mall with more than 100 businesses at one of the city's busiest intersections.
Now CrossRoads sits nearly empty with its future still up in the air. Developers say there's a multi-million dollar plan to bring business and shoppers back.
They say something needs to be done out here at the mall, but they're skeptical if anything will ever get done.
CrossRoads Mall is quiet Monday, but plans for this struggling shopping center are starting to come into focus. Demolition crews set to begin work by the year's end.
Match.
Oh yeah.
So it's Kevin Smith, film Mall Rats 2 here. It's perfect.
Yeah, you hear that, Kevin Smith? Talk about reboots and retro and all that stuff. Mallrats 2, CrossRoads Mall, Omaha. It needs a reboot, a revamp.
Dillards all closed up. Wow. We are beyond the wall that has been closed for a long time to the general public in CrossRoads Mall. That door is open. I'm about halfway tempted to just go up there. Gosh, Sam Goody. That's how old this place is. Yeah, it is. Wow. Bet some people have some memories in here.
smell it. It's so like...
I know.
I don't know. It's
nostalgic.
Musty, yeah.
Let's go this way. So this is what it looks like, Seth. That's the elevator. Ceiling up here. Suncoast music. And there are people directly below us right now. We're not technically supposed to be up here. It's like, I have no idea how many people are in here.
Yeah.
And the people that are in here, who they are.
Yep.
But where we came up, there was nothing that said we couldn't come up here.
No, there were no signs.
There were signs up there. And right here, it just says the escalators are out of service. It's so freaking not to be seen, but we're also not really hiding necessarily. But we in here, fam. We in here. The look of the old registers. There's security up here. Second level. We're just gonna walk down these steps, go straight to the Dillards entrance and look in the window. Behind the security guard. And had we been a few steps late, he would have seen us as he came out of that hallway, but because of where we were at, he didn't see us.
100%. That was insane.
Oh, adrenaline. Adrenaline is insane. Thank you.
How's it going, man?
How you doing?
Good, man. Okay, with the elevator, too.
Mm-hmm. Really cool. I like it.
State of Nebraska, the permit to have it. All the people that have ridden in this elevator. Clearly an old jewelry store. A hanger. That just adds such an effect. What about this? Oh, there's like a lot of stuff. Oh, it's like antique stuff. Oh, pianos.
It's like old furniture.
Yeah, it must be storage of some kind for somebody. I feel like this was a very classy place back in the day because the cash register up the front is like a glassed. Check that out. And then they got like these fancy displays there. I think these pianos are insane. Huh. Going up.